fine at your places. I'm Priyanka Bish from Arden Progressive School, and in today's session we'll be discussing about the topic of third chapter of accountancy, which is admission of a partner. And the topic for today's session is determination of sacrificing or gaining ratio. Before discussing this topic, first we will do a quick revision of the topic which we have discussed in the previous class. We know in the previous class we have learned how to find out the value of goodwill by three methods. So that valuation of goodwill also comes under the adjustment which is required in reconstitution of partnership firm. So reconstitution of partnership firm, it means we know the partnership comes into existence with an agreement where two or more persons agree to share the profits of the business. Now any change in the agreement brings an end to the existing agreement and a new agreement comes into force. So when there is a change in the agreement, it means there is a change in the relationship among the partners. So in such case, although the firm continues, but it amounts to the reconstitution of partnership firm. So we can say reconstitution of partnership firm may happen due to many circumstances, and these circumstances can be, first is change in profit sharing ratio among existing partners. Second, admission of a new partner. Third is retirement of an existing partner, death of a partner, and amalgamation of partnership firm. So as we have discussed about this topic, we know these are the following reasons for the reconstitution of a partnership firm. So in this session, we'll be learning about only the first circumstance, which is change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. Now here is the first situation, which is change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. Now sometimes partners decides to change their profit sharing ratio in future, and this change can be due to change in capital contribution among the partners. Also some partners may actively contribute in the management activities or business activities, but due to this change some partner may get more share in the profits and some partner may get less share in profits. So for all these, necessary adjustment is to be made for all the circumstances which is responsible for reconstitution of partnership firm. So one of the adjustment for the circumstance change in profit sharing ratio among existing partner is determination of sacrificing or gaining ratio. This is the adjustment which is to be made for the circumstance when there is a change in the profit sharing ratio among the partners. One more adjustment we have already studied, that is accounting for goodwill. We have studied how to calculate the value of goodwill in the previous class. So here is the second adjustment, which is determination of sacrificing or gaining ratio. So first we'll be discussing about sacrificing ratio. Now, whenever there is a change in profit sharing ratio among the partners, this means one or more of the existing partner have to surrender some of their old share in the favor of one or more of the other partners. So we can say that sacrificing ratio is the ratio of surrender of profit sharing ratio. We can say that ratio of surrender of profit sharing ratio is sacrificing ratio, where one partner have to sacrifice their old ratio in favor of other partners. And formula of sacrificing or calculating sacrificing ratio is old ratio minus new ratio. So sacrificing ratio is when old profit sharing ratio is more than new profit sharing ratio. So formula is old ratio minus new ratio. Now next we have gaining ratio. So whenever there is a change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners, one or more of the existing partner may gain some portion of share of other partners. So this is known as gaining ratio. Gaining ratio can be ratio of gain of profit sharing ratio. So gaining ratio is when one of the existing partner gains some share of the other partner is known as gaining ratio. And formula for calculating gaining ratio is new ratio minus old ratio. So when new ratio is more than old ratio, this is known as gaining ratio, new ratio minus old ratio. So now we will be solving some numerical questions based on the calculation of sacrificing or gaining ratio. Here the question is, A and B were partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio 2:1. With effect from 1st April 2019, they agreed to share profits and losses equally. Calculate the individual partners' gain or sacrifice due to change in ratio. So as in the question, there are two partners A and B who are sharing the profits and losses in the ratio 2:1. But in future, they agree to share the profits and losses equally, which is 1:1. Now we have to calculate the individual partners' gain or sacrifice due to the change in ratio. Now, as we know, with the change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partner, one partner always has to sacrifice some of the portion of his share to the other partners, and some of the partner gains some portion of share of the next partner. So here we will see how to calculate sacrificing or gaining ratio. Now according to the question, old ratio shared by A and B is old ratio of A and B. So as we know, A and B were sharing the ratio of profit in the ratio 2:1. Now they decide to share the profits in future, which is considered as new ratio, in the ratio 1:1. Now we have to calculate sacrifice or gain. So here let's first calculate A's share of profit. How much profit A has earned, or how much profit share of profit A has sacrificed. So we know the old share of A is 2/3 and new share of A is 1/2. As the old ratio was 2:1, so share of A will be 2/3 and the new share of A is 1:1, share of A will be 1/2. So by calculating this, we get the amount (1/6). Now here we are getting 1/6 as positive value. That means the old ratio is greater than new ratio. So whenever the old ratio is greater than new ratio, it means that the partner has sacrificed some share of profit. So A has sacrificed 1/6 share of profit. We know the formula for calculating sacrifice or gain can be old ratio minus new ratio, or for gaining ratio, new ratio minus old ratio. So we can say the partner has gained the ratio or gained the share when its new ratio is greater than old ratio, and the partner has sacrificed some portion of his share when his old ratio is greater than new ratio. So here we can see old ratio is greater than new ratio. That means A has sacrificed some share of profit. That is 1/6. Now we will calculate B's share of profit. So B's old share is 1 divided by 3 and new share is 1 by 2. So by calculating this, we will get minus 1 by 6. This means the old ratio of B is less than new ratio of B, which means B has gained 1/6 share of profit. So by this, we can conclude that A has sacrificed 1/6 share of profit, whereas B has gained 1/6 share of profit. So this is how we calculate the sacrificing and gaining ratio among the existing partner in the case when there is a change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. Now here is the next question. Question is, A, B and C were partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio 3:2:1. The partners decide to share the future profits and losses in the ratio 2:2:1. Indicate each partner's gain or sacrifice due to change in ratio. Now in this question also, there are three partners A, B and C who were sharing the profits in the ratio 3:2:1. But in future, they decide that they will share the profits in the ratio 2:2:1. So we have to calculate which partner has sacrificed some share of profits and which partner has gained the share of profit. And we can calculate this by putting the formula for sacrificing and gaining ratio. So now according to the question, we know there are three partners. So we will write old ratio of A, B and C. They were sharing the profits in the ratio 3:2:1. This is the old ratio shared among the partners. New ratio is the ratio they decide to share in future, which is 2:2:1. Now we have to see which partner has sacrificed or gained. We know formula for calculating sacrificing ratio is when old ratio is greater than new ratio, which means old ratio minus new ratio. And gaining ratio formula is new ratio minus old ratio. So the partner is said to have gained the ratio when his gaining ratio, his new ratio, is greater than his old ratio. So now first we will calculate A's share of profit, how much share A has sacrificed or gained. So as we know, old ratio of A is 3/6. As we know, the old profit sharing ratio is 3:2:1, where A is sharing 3/6 share. And new ratio of A is 2 divided by 5. As the new profit sharing ratio among the partners, 2:2:1, so share of A will be 2/5. Now by calculating this, we will get the amount. +3/30. Now here the answer is in positive, which means old share of A is greater than new share. So this indicates that A has sacrificed 3/30th share of the profit. This means this is a sacrificing ratio. A has sacrificed some share of profit. Now we will calculate how much share B has gained or sacrificed. So here we can see share of B is 2/6. As the old profit sharing ratio is 3:2:1, share of B will be 2/6. New profit sharing ratio is 2:2:1, so share of B will be 2/5. So here we can see answer is -2/30. So this indicates that B's old ratio is less than new ratio, which means new ratio is greater than old ratio. That means B has gained 2/30th share of profit. So this is a gaining ratio. Now the last partner, which is C, we know the old profit sharing ratio is 3:2:1. So share of C will be 1/6 minus new profit sharing ratio is 2:2:1, where C is sharing a profit 1/5. So by calculating this, we will get -1/30. So here also, partner C, old ratio is less than new ratio, which means C's new profit sharing ratio is greater than old ratio. That means C has gained 1/30th share of profit. So by this, we can conclude that A has sacrificed 3/30th share of profit, whereas B and C has gained 2/30 and 1/30 share of profit respectively. So it is clear in this question, partner A has sacrificed some amount of share of profit. Partner B and C has gained some amount of share of profit. So this is how we will calculate the sacrificing and gaining ratio among the existing partner in the situation when there is change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partner. So in this session, we have learned about the first adjustment required in the circumstance when there is a change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partner. And that adjustment is determination of sacrificing and gaining ratio. We have also studied about the sacrificing and gaining ratio in detail with the formula, and we have solved two questions, numerical questions, based on calculation of sacrificing and gaining ratio. So this topic is completed now. In the next session, we'll be starting a new topic based on third chapter only. That's all for today. Thank you.